Amazing but true. Julia Gillard once called Tony Abbott endearing.
Tony is remarkably loyal, which is very endearing. Even I don't call him the devil. Not all the time, anyway.
Wow. Thank you, Julia.
In fact, the two got on so well on the Today Show, many thought there was a little spark there. But the Prime Minister suddenly discovered this endearing man is a devil. Not just a sexist, but misogynist, someone who hates women.
I will not be lectured about sexism and misogyny by this man. I will not. Misogyny, sexism, every day from this Leader of the Opposition.
Labor's women spread Gillard's smear.
He is certainly guilty of sexism.
The sexism of it, people have had a gutful of that.
I've never seen such a vicious campaign of vilification in federal politics, and the reason for it is this on Tuesday.
With great sadness, I have decided that I should not continue as your speaker.
Let's go back to the start of this scandal. Gillard last year dumped the Honourable Harry Jenkins as Speaker and replaced him with the opposition's sleazy Peter Slipper, known as Slippery Pete. Gillard did it to buy Slipper's vote for insurance. She was about to cheat independent Andrew Wilkie, breaking her promise to him to back Pokey's reforms in return for him making her Prime Minister. She knew Wilkie would hit the roof.
I have no option but to withdraw that support. So I feel very let down. I feel very disappointed.
Cheating Wilkie was one Gillard misjudgment, but choosing Slipper was another. First, Slipper had to stand aside while a staffer sued him for sexual harassment, and police investigated his expenses. Last week came the release of texts to his staffer.
Private text messages were revealed in which he made offensive remarks against a female coalition frontbencher and deeply insulting comments about women in general.
But Gillard made yet another disastrous call, another immoral one. After complaining Abbott was a sexist, she now tried to save a speaker who really was one. On the pathetic grounds, Abbott was worse.
I will not ever see the Leader of the Opposition seek to impose his double standard on this parliament.
Even after Gillard forced Labor's women MPs to vote to save Slipper, he stood down anyway. Slipper understood why he had to go, even if Gillard didn't.
I do understand the arguments of those who argued against me.
That's why Gillard screams she's the victim of sexism. What else can she say for herself? She cheated Andrew Wilkie. To defend herself, she appointed a sleaze as Speaker. And to defend him, she smeared Abbott, father of three daughters, as a hater of women. With Gillard, it's the same story. Catastrophic misjudgment, power above all principle.